Pleasant good morning, church. I greet you in the wonderful name of Jesus Christ. Today I continue my teaching entitled Common Mistakes We Often Make When Believing God for Healing. Today's mistake may come as a surprise to many of you. Today I'm speaking about robbing God. The Bible says in Malachi chapter 3 verse 8, shall a man rob God? The verse went on to explain that we often rob God when we fail to bring our tithes and offerings into the house of God. You need to understand that your giving is directly connected to your well-being. This truth is brought out clearly in verse 11 of that same chapter. This is where God says, when you bring your tithes and offerings into the house of God, God said he will rebuke the devourer for your sake, and he will not destroy the fruit of your ground. The devourer is a reference to none other than Satan, the one who comes to destroy the fruit of your ground. In other words, he comes to eat up and to destroy your wealth. Now, admittedly, the chapter did not speak directly concerning your health. But you need to understand that one of the ways Satan destroys your wealth is by affecting your health, so that he causes you to consume your wealth with medical bills. When we understand what God is saying to us in Malachi, we begin to appreciate that when we give to God, God will in turn turn around and rebuke the enemy, so that he will not touch our wealth, neither our health. If we fail to give to God, it means that God will not rebuke the enemy, and Satan in turn will begin to affect our wealth, and he will do so indirectly also by affecting our health. Now let me give you further evidence to this. When we look in 1 Kings chapter 17, we see that God told Elijah, go to a city called Zarephath. And God said to Elijah, I have commanded a widow woman there to sustain thee. So said, so done. Elijah went and he found the widow woman. It was a time of famine, so food was very scarce. Elijah told the widow woman, bake 2 cakes and give to me. And the woman said that all she had was a little meal in a barrel to bake 2 cakes for she and her son. And after she would eat it, she said she and her son will die. Nevertheless, Elijah gave her instruction and she obeyed. And she baked the cakes and gave to the man of God. And she was rewarded with prosperity. The Bible said she got a miracle of provision, that her barrel of meal never ran out after that, and her cruse of oil never ran out after that. But we need to read even further. In that very same chapter, the Bible also mentions that the woman's son died. And guess what? The same Elijah prayed for the woman's son, and the boy was revived. Now, the miracle of provision was as a direct consequence of the woman's giving towards the man of God, which is synonymous with giving towards God. But not that only. You need to realize that the healing of her son was also a reward for her giving. So in that same chapter, we realize the benefits of giving towards God. It brings financial reward, and it also brings reward in terms of health and healing. So this is my case this morning. I suspect strongly that many of us who are believing God for healing in our bodies and are not getting the answers that we are expecting, it's because we have a loophole in our strategy. Maybe that loophole may very well be that we are not paying our tithes and offering. I'm saying to you, or rather, I dare you, whatever healing you are believing God for, why not take the monies that you commit to those medical bills and medications and make an offering unto God instead. Go to God with your complaint and say, Lord, the enemy is devouring my wealth and my health with medical bills, etc. And you make a seed offering unto God. Commit that money and see God rebuke the devourer. And that may very well be the source of your breakthrough. This is your pastor, Aden Scott, saying, God bless you. Continue to stand in faith and don't just talk the walk, but walk the talk and see God work in Jesus' name. God bless you. Amen.